Lorenzana is holding a press briefing right now. Let's listen in.
Hi, sir. Good morning.
Good morning.
Patricia Mangune, sir, TV5. Sir, was the UP Academe consulted before you decided to abrogate this?
No.
How come, sir? Could you give us an explanation?
The disagreement is a meeting of two minds, ano? It is a meeting of two minds. Kung kaya na lang isa, I think consultation is actually it's not needed. It's useless, ano?
Sir, if I may.
Yes.
I may add, sir. The abrogation of the agreement by the Secretary of National Defense, even if he did that unilaterally, is not in violation of any provisions of contract or any agreement. The fact is, the agreement has been voided by the passage of time. When the agreement was signed in 1989, it was between the Secretary of National Defense, who has under his powers the Armed Forces of the Philippines, being one of its departments. And the AFP then is comprised by the Philippine Army, Philippine Air Force, and the Philippine Navy, and the Philippine Constabulary Integrated National Police. In 1991, with the passage of the PNP law, under the 1987 Constitution, there has to be a one police force which is civilian in character and national in scope. It removed the PNP from the agreement. So therefore, this agreement is void insofar as the PNP is concerned, and there has been a substantial change in the parties to the contract. So therefore, since 1991, this agreement has been voided by the substantial difference in the parties to the contract. That is under the doctrine of rebus sic stantibus, or the fundamental change in the composition or circumstances of the party. Second point, the 1989 agreement is contrary to public policy, because it is inimical to public interest. Why? Because under this agreement, if you have seen that agreement, it says there that the AFP and the police cannot just enter the University of the Philippines, even if they have with them arrest warrants or search warrants. This means that we are depriving the public their right to be ensured to be safe. Paano na lamang po kung mayroong Shabu Laboratory, for instance, sa loob ng University of the Philippines community or campus, and then meron po tayong valid arrest warrant at search warrant? Ang hinihingi po ng agreement na ito, kailangan dadaan muna tayo sa UP administration upang ipaalam bago tayo mag-search. And it violates the rules of court. Nowhere in the rules of court does it say that there's another step that law enforcers should do before they could implement a valid arrest and a valid warrant. Therefore, this is contrary to public policy. And the third among many other reasons that we could cite is the doctrine of qualified political agency, which means that under that doctrine, ang isang secretary ay alter ego ng isang pangulo. In that case, it was during the time of Secretary Ramos as the Secretary of National Defense that he undertook and he signed this agreement. But now that the incumbent Secretary of National Defense has revoked it, has abrogated the agreement, and it was agreed upon by no less than the President of the Republic, then that makes the act of the Secretary of National Defense, now Secretary Lorenzana, valid, legal, and binding.
Okay. Sir, one follow-up. Will we entertain or welcome any appeal from UP, kung meron man?
Yes, I am open to dialogue with them. I appreciate the intercession of a lot of well-meaning people like the members of the Senate who passed a resolution for us to dialogue. Also, Secretary Roque has offered his office for a dialogue between me and Danilo Concepcion. Now, I am willing to talk to him, pero sagutin muna nila kung bakit namatay itong mga taong ito na kasama ng NPA. This is a list of students of UP from all UP campuses na namatay during encounters with the armed forces. Explain to me, bakit ang nangyari ito sa kanila? Why did they fail to protect these young kids from joining this organization that they get killed? As a parent, I really feel sad for these kids na mamatay sila ng ganito. So explain nila yan. If they can explain that, we will talk. If not, then forget it.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you. Ms. Mangune would like to go next. Yes, please.
Secretary, sir, good morning. Mark Makalalan po from DCWB. Sir, senators and congressmen are saying that by terminating unilaterally the 1989 UP-Dendi Accord, the government is providing basis for the public to see the military and police as enemy. Sir, pwede pa makuha reaction ni dito.
How can that be? You know, of all the campuses in the U.S., the Philippines, ang dami namang universities dito. Nandyan yung Ateneo, La Salle, San Beda. Wala naman silang ganyan agreement eh. So why do they exist? The freedom of expression is there, the freedom of academic freedom is there. Lahat ng freedom they enjoy. So how come that they will equate the abrogation of this contract na may militarize namin yung UP? No. Sabi nga kanina, there is a protection, there is an equal protection. Kung ano yung tinatamasang or ni-enjoy ng isa ng nakalayaan should be, or privileges should be enjoyed by all. Now, only UP has this kind of agreement. Why? What makes UP so special to have this kind of treatment or courtesy treatment?
Sir, kung makapagdagdag lang ako. As we speak today, no, ongoing yung coverage ng media doon sa race to 1 million gardens ano, ng Civil Relations Service na nandun mismo sa loob ng Barangay UP Campus. Ito ay pagpapatunay na ang armed forces ay hindi kalaban. Na ang armed forces, pag pumapasok sa mga kampo ng sa mga eskwela, halimbawa, ito na nga particular ang UP. Ngayong araw nito, nangyayari. Ay hindi ibig sabihin nun ay militarisasyon, kung hindi kooperasyon, pagtutulungan sa pagitan ng yung mga sundalo at ng mga mamamayan sa komunidad ng UP upang sa para sa kaunlaran, para sa pagsulong, hindi para sa militarisasyon. So this is just one among the many circumstances that we could cite to you na magandang cooperation between the military and the members of the community of schools, in this particular case ng University of the Philippines.
Okay. Sir, by Representative Ed Salagman filed House Resolution that urges the House Committee on Human Rights to conduct immediate inquiry in aid of legislation to the termination of UP-DND Accord. Bukas po ba tayo na magkaroon po ng inquiry dito?
Yeah, of course. If they call me for, I will welcome that. I will welcome this inquiry.
Okay. Thank you.
Thank you very much for your question. Who would like to go next? I see Shara.
House Committee on Human Rights to conduct immediate inquiry in aid of legislation to the termination of UP-DND Accord. Bukas po ba tayo na magkaroon po ng inquiry dito?
Yeah, of course. If they call me for, I will welcome that. I will welcome this inquiry.
Okay. Thank you.
Thank you very much for your question. Who would like to go next? I see Shara Zambrano.
Hello. Hindi. Can hear you. Sir. Sige.
Nakasan ko na lang, sir.
Nakasan mo na lang. Tanggalin mo yung face shield mo.
Ayan, sir. Check. Better. Okay. Check, paliwanag po, baka pwedeng maging specific kayo. Ano ba yung gustong gawin ng AFP sa loob ng UP campuses na hindi nila magawa? Dahil meron pang UPD and the Accord. Para kasi ngayon very broad yung usapan, yung discussion. Ano ba talaga yung gusto ninyong gawin na hindi nyo magawa noon?
Well, kagaya ng binanggit natin sa kanila, itutok na lang natin doon sa letter and spirit of the agreement. Sinasabi doon na kung meron tayong kailangan gawing pag-aresto o pag-search ano, sa loob ng University of the Philippines, sa campus or community, hindi lang sa UP Diliman or UP Los Baños, kundi sa lahat ng mga UP communities, ay hindi natin po pwedeng gawin nang hindi tayo kinakailangan, nang hindi tayo nagpapaalam o kumukuha ng permiso sa administrasyon ng University of the Philippines, sa OIC, o kung sino mang merong kapangyarihan na mag-grant nito. Itatanong ko po sa inyo, kung kayo po ba ay nangangamba na merong mga droga na maaaring mapunta sa ating mga anak, eh hahayaan nating makatakas yung may-ari ng Shabu Laboratory o gumagawa ng Shabu Laboratory na yon, dahil lamang meron tayong kinakailangang gagawing pagpapaalam sa isang administrasyon. It's very cumbersome ano po, at hindi lang, it's even violative nga of public policy. Pag ginawa po natin yon, delikado na makatakas yung taong ating huhulihin o maitakas ang mga ebidensya o mga bagay na illegal na ginagawa kung hindi tayo kaagad papayagan na magsagawa ng searches. Sa katunayan nga po, dahil nga po sa realidad na yan, pinapayagan ng korte ngayon na yung na ang isang search warrant or warrant of arrest ay pwede mong i-apply kahit saang lugar. Hindi necessarily kung saang lugar ka magagawa ng pag-aresto o pag-alugog. Dahil nga po sa katotohanan na bago natin maisagawa yun, pag nag-apply pa tayo ng search warrant doon o warrant of arrest, bago natin magawa yun, malamang alam na nung taong huhulihin natin o bahay o anumang facility na isi-search natin yung ating pag-a-apply. Ngayon, kung meron na nga po tayong valid search warrant and it boils down to the courts ano, na tumahanap ng probable cause kung bakit sila mag-i-issue ng arrest warrant o search warrant, meron na tayo noon and yet, hindi pa natin magawa. Dahil meron tayong pinangingilagan na agreement na kagaya nito na meron siya University of the Philippines. Para naman po yatang hindi siya naaayon sa kapakanan ng lahat at naaayon sa ano ang dapat na kung meron ka ng search warrant or arrest warrant, eh pwede mo nang hulihin yung isang taong pinaghahanap o kailangan hulihin base sa warrant na yun sapagkat meron pang isang agreement na kailangan nating isalang-alang. And again, it is violation of the rules of court na wala namang sinasabi doon sa rules of court na pag magsasagawa kayo ng pag-aresto o paghahalugob sa ilalim ng isang valid warrant, ay kailangan nyo pang magpaalam sa ibang tao o isang tao bago ninyo legally magawa ang inyong dapat gawin based on those warrants.
Okay, bottom line, ang dapat tanong is hindi yung what do you want to do inside. Kasi ang implication niyan eh, parang papasokin na lang mga military at saka police yung UP. Ano? Ang question siguro is we should focus on what we cannot do to implement the laws of the land because of the agreement. That is the crux of the question, of the problem. Thank you.
Qualify ko lang yung tanong ko kasi yung ano eh yung mga examples na ginagamit then drugs medyo ibang usapin siya. Has there ever been an experience of the security forces na gusto niyong mag-serve ng arrest warrant sa isang purported communist, purported recruiter or member of the NPA inside campus na hindi ninyo nagawa successfully because of this accord?
I think we do not need an example ano kasi dapat lahat pantay-pantay lahat yung mga schools eh. We can do this in Ateneo. Why can't we do it in UP? We don't need an example here. Kasi very clear naman yung agreement. Why do they need an agreement in the first place? Sabi ko, kung na yan, outdated na, obsolete. It has served its purpose. So it's time to terminate it.
Sir, ito po bang concern na ito? Diba na nakalagay sa accord na twice a year you're supposed to convene the parties to this accord, you're supposed to convene and check up on each other. Has this concern ever been brought up? Meron po bang naging troubleshooting, so to speak, na para ma-solve yung pangangailangan ninyo with the UP officials?
No. It's my assumption that the Secretary of Defense, I think there's not been any consultation between the UP.
Now, teka muna. Kasi, let's go back to the agreement, ano. I go back to my agreement na bakit kailangan ng UP ito at hindi kailangan ng ibang eskwelahan? Why do they need it? Tell me, bakit kailangan ko ikaw, taga-UP ka? Ba't mo kailangan ito?
Atenista po ako, SMB.
So, tell me. Atenista ka para
well,
hindi ka.
Ang alam ko lang sa history, no, for this was triggered by an arrest of a student activist who was
1989. That was too long ago. 30 years ago na yan eh. Yes. Times have changed, Sarah. Wala na kami inaris na tao doon since then. So I think this agreement has outlived its usefulness.
Sir, baka may dagdag ko lang, sir.
Kasagay.
Yung doktrina ng Equal Protection Clause, no? Other schools can invoke it, no? If that could be accorded to UP, why can't they enjoy the same? At sabi nga ni Secretary Lorenzana, it shouldn't be deprived, they shouldn't be deprived, or this privilege, or this agreement, or this agreement that happened between UP and the DND may also be demanded by other schools. So sa ilalim ng doktrina na yan, lahat sila hihingi ng ganyang pribileyo, lahat ng ganyang kurtesiya na ipinagkaloob dati ng Department of National Defense.
Let's go further, no? Bigyan na rin natin lahat ng schools, pati elementary, bigyan na natin. Then ay siguro sa susunod, hihingi din yung LGU na magpapaalam sa kanila yung polis bago makapagtayo ng presyento. So, let us be fair to everybody here. Masyado nang napapaboran yung UP because of this agreement. So, kung sa kanila that in doing this, we should give it to Ateneo, Lasal, San Beda, and every schools here in Metro Manila. Para pantay-pantay. Sabi nga ni Attorney Arevalo, equal protection of the law.
Yung contention po ng UP is because of precisely of their history of student activism, and there was a concrete incident that triggered this. Yun po yung contention nila na this isn't an example. Sabi nila, this is not an example of special treatment. This is a product of an incident.
Kaya nga, that was just 3 years after martial law, so fresh pa yung sa isipan natin yung mga gulo-gulo dyan sa UP. And so, this was requested by the UP President then, Abueva, na bigyan sila ng, para hindi makapasok yung mga sundalo, ano. But that was 32 years ago, Chara. No? And, kaya nga, I go back to these kids that were recruited and killed sa UP, ano. Ito lang. We concentrate on this. We do not suppress legitimate dissent. Mag-assembly kayo dyan. This morning when you woke up, nakakapag-tweet kayo, you can form a demonstration there. Nobody will touch you. Ang ayaw namin ay itong mga nagtatago dyan at nagre-recruit ng mga bata, binibigyan ng baril at makipaglaban against the government and they are being killed. Ito yung nasa records lang namin. Marami pang nawala na hindi na natin alam kung saan sila namatay.
Yes, ma'am.
I don't know if you have been asking for secretary, but there have been a lot of...
Sorry, Ms. Marisol, kindly...
Paki ulit.
Morning, sir. I don't know if this is for secretary, but there have been a lot of reaction already, rallies right there and then. Ang daming panawagan, dialogue, and then for consideration daw po ang review. Ano po ang reaction niyo dito, sir?
Go back to me, ano? Sagutin mo lang nila ito. UP should answer me truly kung bakit nagkagarito yung mga estudyante ng UP. Sila lang naman pinakamarami. There are a few from other schools, but the most number of kadres sa ka-MPA na namapatay namin ay galing sa UP. Sagutin nila yan. Then we will dialogue.
For now, Secretary, close for reconsideration and dialogue na po.
Open ako. Paliwanag lang nila ito.
Sir, after UP, what's next daw po?
What's next? Nothing. They will exist as before. They can do anything they want. Yung sinasabi nilang infringement of academic freedom, I think Attorney Rivalo will explain to you what academic freedom is.
Madalas po nating naririnig na yung ginagawa daw na ito, specifically ito raw, ay magiging violation ng academic freedom. Narinig na po ba natin ang paliwanag nila kung anong academic freedom ang nababiolate dahil sa pagsasara nitong agreement na ito? Dahil kung wala po silang malinaw na babanggitin kung anong academic freedom ang nakocurtail nito, ay tayo po ang magbabanggit sa kanila. Ayon po sa dinesisyon ng kaso ng Supreme Court sa De La Salle University Incorporated versus Court of Appeals, sinabi po ng Supreme Court doon na ang academic freedom ay dinidefine bilang pagbibigay ng liberty o kalayaan sa mga academic institution na una, pumili kung sino ang magtuturo. Ikalawa, ano ang ituturo? Ikatlo, paano siya ituturo? At ikaapat, sino ang pwedeng mag-aral sa kanilang universidad? Yan po ang apat na pumapaloob sa tinatawag na academic freedom according to that ruling of the Supreme Court. Eh wala naman pong nababiolate na apat na ganito sa University of the Philippines sa pagputol nitong agreement na ito. At kung pinangangambahan po natin na maging itong apat na ito ay ma-violate dahil na naputol itong agreement na ito, huwag po silang mag-alala. Because academic freedom is enshrined in the Constitution, not in this agreement. So even if this agreement is abrogated and voided by the passing of time, by the reasons I explained earlier, and by the act of the Secretary of National Defense as confirmed and validated by the President of the Republic, then wala po silang dapat pangambahan sapagkat, inuulit ko po, ang academic freedom according to those to that definition and what encompasses academic freedom is enshrined in the Constitution, not in the four corners of this agreement. So kahit wala po yung agreement na yan, ang kanilang tinatawag na academic freedom ay mananatili. Kaya po sana yung mga ibang mga kasamahan natin, mga kapwa ko graduates ng University of the Philippines, sana po wag na natin gamitin itong misleading na issue. Wala naman pong academic freedom na maku-curtail o may impinge dahil sa pagsasara ng agreement ito. Dahil inuulit po natin, ang academic freedom, even according to that definition, is enshrined in the Constitution, not in this agreement.
David Santos was raising his hand.
Good morning.
Good morning.
You've always been seen as a liberal, you know, thinker sa administration natin, sex, no? You speak your mind, even if this may be unpopular sometimes within the cabinet or within among your defense colleagues. Can you walk us through to this decision process to finally put an end to this agreement? Considering na, as pointed out by General Arevalo, since 1991, pwede na makonsider void ito with the separation of the PNP doon sa arrangement ng agreement. What took us this, you know, this long, no? Itong matatagal na panahon to finally, at this time, at your turn, to end this?
Yeah, I've been thinking about abrogating the this agreement since a couple of years back, nung malaman ko ito, no? And they were trying to see how it works, you know. And so it came a time when talagang itong mga recruitment nila sa loob ay talagang lumalaki. Lumalaki the incidence of students being killed or former students of UP being killed in the encounters. Dumadami na. So I think that this agreement has outlive its usefulness na. It's not helping the people. It is not helping the students. Kasi nandyan sa loob, naka-embed niya sa loob yung mga nag-recruit. I'll read you some of the, ano, yung listahan na. Itong si, ano, Josephine Lapera was killed in the UP Manila. Anong pa niya? Anong organization niya? Gabriela. Giancarlo Alberto, Anak Bayan. Christine Poche, League of Filipino Students. They all died, huh? They all died. Rica Noel Monte, Gabriela, I can go down the line, lahat mo, kabilang, kabataan, LFS, everything. So it confirms our accusations that these organizations are fronting for the Communist Party of the Philippines.
Sir, baka pwedeng magdagdag ako.
Yeah.
Matagal na po tayong pinahihirapan ng teroristang CPP-NPA. 52 taon na po. At sa loob ng mga panahong yon, katakot-takot na hirap, paghihirap ang inabot ng ating mga sambay ng Pilipino. Kasama na po yung mga kawawang magulang na ginagapang ang kanilang mga anak para lang makapagtrabaho. Tatay din ako. May anak din akong gustong mag-aral sa UP. Subalit, sumasang-ayon ako na dapat walang ganitong klaseng agreement. Ang bottom line po, matagal na nating ginagawa ang mga iba't ibang hakbangin upang matapos na natin ang problemang ito sa insurgencia sa CPP-NPA. And this is one of those measures na kailangan natin gawin among the many things that we are now doing para matapos natin ang ating problema sa insurgency. Laging tinatanong ng sambay ng Pilipino, bakit umabot ng ganito katagal? Anong ginagawa ng sandatang lakas ng Pilipinas? Hindi naman po tayo humihinto. That's why we are continuing with our operations and we are trying other and doing other means, ways, and forms in order to achieve our objective. And this is one of those.
Okay. Please understand na wala akong, we have nothing against UP. This is not an attack against UP or the alumni. Gusto lang namin malinis yung UP sa mga bad elements sa loob. I have two kids who went to UP. One of them is here. Ang nakikinig sa ngayon dito eh. And so, this is not against UP. It is a way of protecting the students. Para wala nang masama dito. Hopefully, wala nang masali dito sa mga mamamatay, mga kabataan na galing sa UP. I have nothing against UP. We want to protect UP and the students.
Just a quick follow-up lang. Sabi niyo nga po, well, you pointed out that list, sir, and many of those, if not all, who died were killed in encounters, sir. Well, obviously, outside of UP campuses. But you also pointed out na kaya sila naging, well, as you would like to believe, na naging part ng communist movement because they were recruited in the campuses of UP. Have we conducted operations, sir? Nagkaroon ba ng mga operations ang ating security forces na nahamper in going after itong supposed recruitment, itong going after mga taong humihikayat supposedly sa mga estudyante na sumali sa communist movement, sir, na hindi natin naigop na sagawa dahil sa agreement na ito?
No, we have not. I think we have not gone to, we cannot even conduct any patrol ng police. Wala nga eh. Kasi nga bawal eh. Magpaalam ka muna tapos sasabihin nila siguro what is your purpose in coming here. And remember that UP Diliman is not only a school. It is a community. Barangay nga yan eh. You go around the Metro Manila, lahat ng barangay may presinto ng police. Why does UP do not have this? And meron silang police force. They are the only campus that have a private army na pinanganulan nila, yung pwede nilang utusan. So, talagang it is an equal treatment here among colleges.
Sir, we can do the operation, sir. Pwede niyong isagawa yung operation to go after these recruiters inside the UP campuses, even if existing itong agreement, sir.
Yes, we can. Ang problema lang dyan, magpapaalam ka muna. You cannot surprise these people, ginagawa namin, na mong may-ari. Pati na aristo nga eh. Arrest.
Pati search. Eh.
Search warrant. Magpaalam ka ba sa administration? Where in the court, rules of court can you see that? None. So, parang nandun, sabi nga ni Secretary Speron kahapon na nag-uusap kami about this. Sabi niya, lumalabas na elitista itong ano, na they consider themselves as above the rest because gusto nilang itrato sila ng special. And he is from UP. Nag-aral sa UP yan, si Secretary Spiron.
I'm afraid
One last, sir. So, have you, pero nagkaroon ng attempts. I mean, kasi sabi niyo, sir, parang napapangunahan tayo, sir, ng reservation natin because of the deal. So, medyo hindi natin itutuloy. But have there been attempts man lang? At least, whether, kasi sir, to be honest, may mga alam din kaming nagkaroon ng mga intelligence operations, mga discrete operations to monitor itong mga grupong na ito. Now, without necessary, even if nag-exist yung deal, nagagawa pa rin naman ng security forces yung kanilang trabaho. Are you saying, sir, na despite the presence of, I mean, existing itong deal, hindi talaga nagawa ever?
Why even attempt kung pagpapaalam ka pa? Why even attempt? Wala, it defeats the purpose. Eh. Kaya ang ginagawa ng militar sa kapulis, sinabangan na lang sa labas, outside of UP. Doon nila na inventoryan sa mga kabundukan, iba-ibang lugar.
Unfortunately, that's all the time we have this morning.
Sayang, dami ko pa naman tanong, Sek.
Sige. Bonus yata, sir.
Okay, the secretary says that.
Two questions, sir. Doon sa, susugan ko lang yung pinapunto ni David, na kung nahihirapan kayo dahil doon sa added step na kailangan magpaalam sa UP, does that mean that hindi buo yung tiwala ninyo doon sa aabisuhan ninyo na hindi ititimbre doon sa gusto ninyong arestuhin sa loob ng campus, kaya tayo nahihirapan?
Hindi naman sa walang tiwala, but it defeats the purpose of a search warrant or a warrant of arrest. Bakit tayo doon sa equal protection nga eh? Bakit kailangan, sa ibang eskwelahan, hindi naman kailangan yan eh. Bakit kailangan ng UP? Bakit kailangan magpaalam sa UP?
Sir, ito, ang huli ko, UP has a very vibrant, active student. Ang UP po meron siyang very vibrant student activist community. Alam naman
UP lang bang meron yan?
Sila po, we're talking about UP at the moment, sir.
So
ang tinatanongin ko po, Sec, is ano na po ang gagawin ng security forces, halimbawa kung mayroong rally sa UP na sinasabing tutulan ng Administrasyong Duterte, pag may mga student groups na namimigay ng flyers na sinasabing kinikriticize yung mga polisiya ng pamahalaan, ano po ang gagawin
na gagawin ngayon? Namin? Wala. They can shout their lungs to high heavens. They can put in the graffitis around UP.
Thank you for your question.
Wala kaming pakialam doon.
Dinagang ko lang, sir, yung KSND. Again, the abrogation of this agreement is not an impairment of their freedom of speech, of assembly, or redress of grievances. Pagkalabas na pagkalabas nga nung statement ni SND, abrogating it, nag-rally sila eh. Nakakita ba kayong hinuli sa kanila? They shouted to up to high heavens, di ba? Nag-protest, nag-demonstration. Wala namang nanghuli sa kanila. It's because so long as you are doing it within what is legal, what is allowed, what is protected, and we are there to protect you even, to ensure that you could exercise these liberties of speech, of assembly, and of redress of grievances. So yan ang pagpapatunay po. Itong apat na punto po, in closing, gusto ko lang banggitin. What is this abrogation? This abrogation is not what? It is not a curtailment of academic freedom. Number two, the abrogation of this agreement does not impair their freedom of expression, their freedom of assembly, and redress of grievances. Third, the abrogation of this agreement, even if done unilaterally, does not violate any obligations and contracts or provisions of agreement that I have mentioned earlier. And finally, this is not an attack against UP or any other academic institutions. As a matter of fact, this is an act to protect and to ensure na ang ating mga eskwelahan at ang ating mga kabataan, ang eskwelahan ay hindi mapapasok nito mga terorista na malinaw na malinaw na binanggit ng ating butihing kalihim ng tanggulang bansa ang listahan ng mga estudyante ng UP na namatay. Ito pa lang ang naka-record, ano? Wala pa yung iba, sabi niya nga. Masiguro natin na hindi mapapasok ng mga recruiter. At higit sa lahat, ang ating mga anak na iginagapang natin ng pag-aaral, gagawing araw ang gabi, makapag kumita lamang ng sapat para mapag-aral ang mga anak upang masiguro na sila naman ay masisiguro nila na ang kanilang anak na kanilang iginagapang ay makakatapos sa pag-aral at makakamtan din ang kanilang pangarap at minimiti para sa kanilang mga anak. Yun lang po, importante yung 4 points.
Okay, absolute last question na po. Yes, please go ahead.
Yes, sir. My name is Spencer Ross from AUP Radio. So, sir, to lighten up the conversation po, netizens are asking if you have seen Chloe on crash landing on you because of the some netizens are curious about it. Kasi trending ito po sa social media at dun sa, especially sa Facebook at saka sa Twitter, kung nakita niyo nga raw po or napanood niya raw si Chloe. Kasi yes. Ginamit niyo siya
yes,
sa isang
statement niyo. Yes, from the start to the finish.
Wow. So that's it po. Actually, sir, one follow-up questions. May mga states and colleges and universities or firms and organizations pa po ba na aside from UP na may ganito klaseng agreement?
Meron ba tayo? Wala, ano?
Meron daw, sir.
POP daw, but I haven't seen. There's a rumor about POP having an agreement with the DND, but I haven't seen a copy. And former secretary, minister pala siya, minister Enrile, denies that he ever signed that. But if you can present to me a copy, I will abrogate it also.
Yes, sir. Sir, last na talaga to. The decision and the idea of terminating the contract between UP and the national government is somehow or connected or rooted from former cadres like Eric and other witnesses who shared their testaments under the CPP and PANDF that the government should look into it, the states and university. If that's the case, do you think it's a great avenue or channel to end local communist conflict?
Yeah, those are part of the evidences that we have. You know? Marami pa. Other former cadres are talking about it. If you have been following Bobby Tiglao, talagang he documented nung the start, hanggang yung pag-ispat nila ng mga estudyante, yung pagkakaibigan nila, hanggang sa may ibunusod nila yan, may buyo nilang sumama sa kanila.
So
nobody disputed his accounts. And he was an activist himself.
Yes, sir. Thank you so much, Pope. Okay.
I hope yung ating mamamayan ay naintindihan nila kung bakit na terminate itong agreement na to. Sa kabutihan po lahat ng Latin ito. Kabutihan ng mga estudyante sa UP especially. Dahil doon ang gagaling lahat ng mga casualties na binanggit ko. Now, I would like to reply to the to allegations of President Danilo Concepcion. Ang sabi niya, what happened, this abrogation will have a chilling effect. Will have a chilling effect on the educational system or the colleges. Ang ibig sabihin niyan, for the past 30 years, yung mga walang agreement, they were living in chill. Takot na takot sila? Hindi naman na. So I don't think that's a very accurate agreement. And I assure you, everybody that we will protect you, wala mag-aabuso, and we will allow you to do legitimate dissent, assemblies, whatever. Mag-tweet kayo dyan. Wala kaming pakialam doon. Basta within the bounds of the law. It is when you start plotting against the government, hindi na maganda yan. We are the protector of the people. Yun ang aming sinumpaan. We have shown our oath that we are going to support and defend the Constitution. Any people who will violate that ay kalaban namin. Maraming salamat po.
Thank you very much, Secretary Lorenzana. I'd like to thank the panel for attending this and of course our friends from the media. Maraming salamat mo sa inyo lahat. Have a good day.
You're watching the country's defense chief, Delfin Lorenzana, and the military, who just gave a briefing to discuss the Duterte administration's recent termination of the 1989 accord between UP and the Department of National Defense. Now, this was a pact which was established to protect students from campus militarization. Major General Edgar Arevalo spoke first as the spokesperson of the AFP. He said that no consultation is needed to rescind this accord with a state university. He also said that this accord is officially deemed void as it runs contrary to public policy. He said that the termination is considered legal and binding as the controversial accord defeats the purpose of a warrant. Now, Secretary Lorenzana expressed his willingness to hold a dialogue with UP on the matter, but he did call on the university to explain the deaths of students in government encounters. Now, the military did say that they welcome an inquiry into the matter of this agreement. However, they maintain their position that the UP-DND Accord has served its purpose, and now it's time to terminate it to protect the students. They add that this move does not infringe on academic freedom, the freedom of speech, the freedom of assembly, nor is it an attack against UP per se. They're saying they're doing it to prevent insurgency and to combat the communist movement. Now, UP was singled out, however, because they did say that UP has, quote, a private army. Now, a former member of the High Court, Theodore Te, says that this is now a legal issue to be settled outside both parties as the government terminated this agreement unilaterally and because UP is not recognizing it. He says that UP can go to court or ask Congress for assistance in settling this matter. Now, while there are those in the government that are in favor of this move, there are also those that oppose it, namely Senators Risa Ontiveros, Nancy Binay, Ralph Recto, Laila De Lima, Franklin Drilon, and Joel Villanueva, all graduates of UP. They themselves are condemning the termination of this pact. Now, UP and the Department of National Defense are now being encouraged to engage in a peaceful dialogue to resolve this matter. And